أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. The previous khutbah, which is about 2 weeks ago approximately, I spoke about the fitan, and specifically I talk about the fitna of money, fitna tul mal. We mentioned the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ فِتْنَةٍ وَفِتْنَةُ أُمَّةِ الْمَالِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every nation has a trial or had a trial. And the trial of my ummah is money. Today, I would like to continue with this subject from a different angle about money. Because money, as Allah said, وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. You love wealth so much. And Allah says, وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٍ. Indeed, mankind, his nature, mankind, that he in love with money. Will you kindly please fill the gaps between yourself and move forward? جزاكم الله خيرا. And today, I want to tell you the smallest story. And sometimes stories make some of you wake up and like to listen. This part of our nature, we hear things for entertainment. We don't want admonishment. But my story, why the Sahaba was upset. Or let me rephrase it and say why some of the Sahaba felt sad. Some of the Sahaba came and complained to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and saying, O Prophet of Allah, ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور والدرجات العلى من الجنة يصلون كما نصلي يصلون كما نصلي ويصومون كما نصوم غير أن لهم فضل مال يتصدقون به ويعتقون وليس لنا ما نتصدق به. It's a sad story for the Sahaba. Yes, it is a sad story for the Sahaba. Something is missing out of their life. What it is? The dollar? Yes, the dollar. The dirham and the dinar. But for what? To buy a second house? To open a third and fourth gas station? To continue carrying the haram? No. Say, O Prophet of Allah, the people of wealth, our brothers, those the one who possess money, they had achieved the highest ranks in Jannah. Our brothers, they are our brothers, but something is bothering us. What? Because they got a higher ranks in Jannah, and we don't. How? Say, if it comes about a prayer, they pray and we pray. If it comes about fasting, they fast. We also can fast. But they have a surplus money. So they free the slaves and give in charity. And we don't have money to give in charity. So we feel sad, we feel bad about it, that we don't have money to give in sadaqah. That we don't have money not to buy a dollar over dollar and thousand over a thousand and account over account, and your wallet is full with credit cards. One is silver, one is gold, one and business. No, not for any reason. They want to get to Jannah, and they want to get what is the other people who have the money getting from Jannah. But they don't have it. So they are not complaining that they don't have money, so they could not build a house or go to the second and the third floor. Or that sixth gas station, the famous big name in town. No. If it's Salah, we equal. If it's fasting, is equal. Going to the mosque, we equal, everything, we are equal, but they have more money. What they doing with this money? Fi sabilillah. And now they can get more from Jannah, which we could not. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with his big heart, he said, indeed Allah had made for you what you can give in charity. فَإِنَّ كُلَّ تَسْبِيحَةٍ صَدَقَةٍ وَكُلَّ تَحْمِيدَةٍ صَدَقَةٍ وكل تكبيرة صدقة وأمر بالمعروف صدقة ونهي عن المنكر صدقة وفي بضع أحدكم صدقة. قالوا يا رسول الله أيأتي أحدنا شهوته وفيها وله فيها صدقة؟ قال: أو لو وضعها في حرام أكان عليه وزر؟ قالوا: نعم. قال: فذلك. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you have the means that you can get from Jannah what they got. You have means to give in charity and sadaqah. Because every time you say Subhanallah, you are giving, you are receiving reward of a charity. When you say Alhamdulillah, you are receiving a reward of making a charity. When you say Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, any of these phrases, you are giving in charity. You give in a charity. And for you to enjoy the good, is a charity and to forgive.